Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin.
The subscribe button turned into a merch plug? That's, very YouTube, I think.
Over the years, there have been several claims of a mouse or rat being found in a can of soda. Disgusting, right? Well, brace yourselves, because it kinda gets worse. In 2012, a small lawsuit against PepsiCo for one of those incidents revealed something much more disturbing. In their denial that a mouse could be found in a can of Mountain Dew, a veterinarian pathologist hired by the company claimed that it was impossible because the soda would have dissolved the mouse into a jelly-like substance by the time they opened the can. You heard me right. They claimed that you wouldn't find a mouse carcass, but rather mouse goo. But is that even possible? Can soda actually dissolve a small animal? Yes, it can. Well, sort of. And no pun intended. While soda may be able to dissolve certain parts of an animal, some aspects may survive. Mice and rats can be quite strong swimmers, but when they are fully submerged in any liquid, they will drown in just a few minutes. Since sodas can have a shelf life ranging from 3 to 9 months, there is plenty of time for the rodent to dissolve with the help of common chemicals found in these drinks. The sharp, tangy flavor in soda is due to citric or phosphoric acid, which have pHs similar to that of the hydrochloric acid in your stomach. Scientists believe that these chemicals could eat away bones and teeth. In a famous 2004 study, soaking human molars for just 2 weeks resulted in a 1% loss of tooth enamel volume in Coca-Cola, a 6% loss in Mountain Dew, and a 8% loss in Diet Mountain Dew. However, even after months in soda, the collagen and soft tissue may still remain. In order to disintegrate the animal completely, other digestive enzymes may be needed. But besides being able to partially digest a mouse, soda has other not-so-great qualities as well. A typical 12-ounce can of soda contains 7 to 10 teaspoons of added sugar. That's equal to 30 to 42 grams of sugar, or 110 to 150 calories, without any nutrients. Sugary soft drinks like soda can increase your risk for type 2 diabetes, heart disease, gout, and obesity. One meta-analysis combining the results of 11 questionnaire-based studies found that people who drank one or more cans of soft drinks a day had a 26% greater risk of developing type 2 diabetes than people who rarely drank them. Other studies have found a 20 to 40% higher risk of coronary heart disease depending on how many soft drinks were consumed. So, it may be time to cut down on all those sugary drinks. If not for your health, at least to avoid finding a half-dissolved mouse carcass floating in your beverage. Also, I think mouse goo is the new name for my band. So, do you drink soda? If so, how often? Let me know in the comment section below, or tell me, what should I talk about next? Curious to know what would happen if you never stopped drinking coffee? Check out this video. This is cup number one of the day, and for the sake of this scenario, we're going to consider one cup of coffee as 8 ounces. Craig won't be consuming anything else. After the first sip, the coffee is quickly absorbed by the gastrointestinal tract. Thank you so much for watching and liking this video. As always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.